This is Susan Bradley for CSO Online. Well, what a difference a week makes. I live in the state of California where we are in a shelter-in-place order, which means we're doing our best to work from home and other techniques. I know New York is in the same situation and probably other states will go that way too. This is probably causing you, the information technology person, to be on the forefront of the battle to keep businesses of all size able to be working from home, even if it means the majority of your workers are now remoting in from home. If you're one of these folks, you may have noticed how technology has risen to the challenge in some ways, and in other ways, the vendors have realized that we have too much on our plates right now to deal with all the issues. Here's how some of the ways that the COVID-19 pandemic is clearly impacting our Windows security posture. First off, releases and servicing. You've probably seen that Chrome 81 did not ship on schedule, and Google announced that they're pausing upcoming Chrome and Chrome operating system releases. They emphasized instead they'll ensure that releases are stable, secure, and they'll focus on security rather than features. Microsoft as well announced that they're pushing off the end of life for 1709. It was going to come to an end in April, but now security-only releases will be released for that platform from May until October. The final update date has been really pushed out to October 13th, 2020 instead. It remains to be seen if Office 365 and Office Click to Run releases will also be impacted by the COVID adjustments. You'll want to keep an eye on the Office 365 roadmap and any Office 365 alerts you get for any impact on those platforms. Remember as well, if you have any excess service capacity in your data center or in your local environment, you can stand up 180-day trial versions of various of the Windows Server editions. Windows Server 2019 and Windows Server 2016 both allow you to trial it out for 180 days. So if you need excess capacity quickly, remember that you can download an ISO and put it in Hyper-V. You can quickly set up remote desktop server or RD gateway solutions with these two platforms. Also, remember that you can set up an OpenVPN installation so you can have OpenVPN server. And don't forget to check out the VPN connectivity you have in your firewall environment. Microsoft came out with instructions on how to optimize your Office 365 traffic so it doesn't go through your firewall and instead goes locally. Many VPN solutions already include that capability, and they also provide web filtering to your home users as well. So review your options in your VPN solutions to see what you can do to limit the traffic going back to your home, your offices, and instead maximize that throughput to your various locations. Also look for other solutions through Azure AD. You can use Azure to integrate your remote desktop gateway infrastructure using the network policy server. You can also secure the RDP connection using Azure Multifactor. And finally, there's step-by-step protecting RD gateway with Azure Multifactor. All of these can be done in a relatively short amount of time. Already several ISPs and the CEO of AT&T has indicated that the impact of all this work from home has changed network traffic. Before it would go out of the data centers, and now that he sees a lot of blending of the traffic coming in from home users. You may want to reach out to your home users and let them know how to adjust home cameras so it uses lesser bandwidth. You can also let them know how to customize the throttling inside their home networks as well. And last but not least, don't forget to warn them about COVID-related malware. Don't forget to send out prevention tips on how they can make sure that they're not scammed and tricked. Last but not least, make sure to check out the Tech Talk from IDG. We've got some tips on working from home, Zoom setup, COVID-19 and remote networking, and all sorts of other tips to keep you safe. For everyone at CSO Online, this is Susan Bradley. Stay safe and stay well.